the BIM means building information modeling. So in the building information modeling, we just show the building and then building related components like electrical, mechanical, plumbing, those kind of discipline related modeling works. We just show through the softwares for easy understanding purpose. Okay, so the BIM is not a product or a property. It's a software program. It is a set of integrated process built on coordinated reliable information about a project from design through construction and into operation. So simply I just mentioned building information modeling is a BIM. Okay, so building related information, we are providing the modeling. That's the reason it's called BIM. Okay, the next stage, why we are choosing BIM in the construction industry. So in the construction industry, the first stage is 2D drawings. Okay, once the 2D drawing was prepared, then the persons were going to prepare the 3D model. Okay, so the connection between 2D and 3D is very important here. In the initial stage, that means before enter into the BIM, what happened? We prepare the 2D drawing first. With the help of the 2D drawing, we prepare the 3D model. With the help of the 2D drawing, we prepare the 4D. That means timeline and simulation works. And then with the help of 2D, we prepare the cost estimation. With the help of 2D, we prepare the facility management like 7D. Okay. So what happened? If any changes happen in the 2D, we need to rework the 3D model again. We need to rework the timeline simulation. And then we need to rework the cost estimation. And also we need to key in the information about the building or the facility management details we need to key in. Okay. So it's taking a lot of time to rework those processes. To prevent the situation, we are incorporating the BIM in the construction industry. Okay. So once we are incorporating the BIM, what happened? We prepare the 3D model first. We don't go for the 2D. We just prepare the 3D model first. With the help of 3D model, we extract the 2D drawings. We extract the 4D, that means timeline simulation information. And then we extract the cost estimation, that means 5D. We extract the scheduling, those kind of information, quantity takeoff, everything from the 3D model, that is called 6D. We extract the facility management like 7D from the 3D model. If any changes happen in the 3D model, for example, if you move a door from one location to another location, or if you change the type of door, those all the information, that means 2D, 4D, 5D, 6D, 7D, all the information will be changed simultaneously. We don't need to spend much time to change one by one. So that is the main benefit of BIM we are incorporating in the construction industry. It's okay, right? The next. So what are the current trends in the BIM? So what are the, in the BIM field, first, what we are doing, that means only we prepare the 3D model initially. After that, we incorporating the class coordination, that means 4D. So if any classes between both services, for example, ducting with the electrical light fixtures, those classes we can find from the class coordination part. That's one we can see that in our Navisworks software, that is different. Okay, so now in the current trends, what are the advanced technology we are incorporating in the BIM means, these are the list which I provided here. Modular construction and prefab. So that means prefabrication is a different platform in the BIM industry. So that one I will explain later, because this is a different, okay. IoT also I explain later. Augmented reality and virtual reality, that means VR, AR and VR. So once the model was prepared, those with the help of the Google or any other VR glasses, we can see the whole model through in a single location. We don't go to the site in the same, in our office location also. Otherwise we have a BIM room, individual BIM room in our project or in our office. With the help of that one, we can see the whole site in a single location and order quickly from the model, mobile cloud applications. So that one is the latest advanced technology. That means like some other softwares like Revisto, Bentley Navigator, those softwares are available in mobile also. So the person who go to the site work, they can take the picture of the location. That means any classes or any miscellaneous happen in the site, they just take a snapshot and send to the modeling people at the same time. That one's called mobile cloud applications. And BIM to the construction 3D laser scans and drones. This one means This one, we have an individual category of a modeling process, like design stage, construction stage, documentation stage, as-built stage. So in the as-built stage is different from our modeling process. That, for example, once our model was done, is bit different from the as-built model, because the site people, they can adjust the model as per the site situation. So that, for example, those model need to be, those changes need to be reflected in our current model. That means how 100% need to be how the site model looking like, the same our model also need to be updated. For those purpose, we are using 3D scanner. Okay, this scanner help us to scan the total room with the total data, and then they give us a point cloud information, like point cloud data. So those data is as-built drawings, we are using that one. Otherwise, if we are going to demolish a building, so for that purpose, we just scan the building first and then we just start the demolish. For the record of the building, how it can be looking like that. Those kind of information we can get from the 3D laser scans and drones. From my experience, recently we done a project in the Singapore, like tunnel project. It's a tunnel project. The tunnel already has existing tunnel. In the existing tunnel, they are planned to incorporate the water mist system, fire protection system. For that purpose, government need us to prepare the total tunnel model in our 3D. So for that purpose, we scan the total tunnel, and then with the help of the scanning data, the scanning output should be point cloud data, that is POD. The explanation of the file format is POD. With the help of that one, we prepare the total, we just prepare the total tunnel first, existing tunnel first, and then we prepare the new surfaces. Then customer software for our get all in one. Okay, so for example, previously we have individual software for architecture, individual software for structure, individual for MEP previously. Now we have customer software like divid archi structure MEP in a single software. That one is called get all in one. And going green means now most of the countries are planned to incorporate a green building. Okay, so green building means energy less, and then pollution-less building. So those kind of concept also they are going to incorporate in our BIM. So that one I mentioned, going green. So this is the state of art in this field. As I mentioned, we have a n number of steps. They're like conceptual design, detailed design, analysis, documentation, fabrication, construction, 2D and 5D, construction logistic, operation and maintenance, demolish or renovation. So this kind of steps we have in our BIM field. Okay, in this BIM field, we have, for example, first we need to prepare the programming, like what kind of output we are going to provide, what kind of details we need, those kind of information we need to take care first, and then we just go for the conceptual design. Conceptual design is a basic model, like there is no more information in that. For example, if I need a chair, okay, that is concept. The chair should be a rolling chair or any flexible chair. You can adjust the height. That is different. Conceptual design means I need a chair. Okay. The next step is detailed design. You can incorporate some more information about the chair, like how much size you want, how much width you want, how much height you want. Those kind of details is called detailed design. Okay. Analysis means how much load the chair should be taken. For example, 60 kg can, 70 kg can. Those kind of analysis can be performing the analysis part. Okay, I just compare with building as a chair. Okay, so don't confuse, it's just an example. And then documentation means the chair was prepared well, that means the design was done, length, width, height, and then how, what is the type of the chair, how much load should be taken, those kind of details we gather. That detail should be incorporating your documentation part. So the documentation part help us to prepare the chair in the fabrication part. Okay, the fabrication is, they are preparing the chair with the details which you given to us. Those details is there. Construction 4D and 5D is like time and time linear, and then cost estimation. Those is comes under 4D and 5D. Construction logistic, operation and maintenance should be the end of the part. That means once the chair was finished, how much is going to be, how long it should be the chair was working, or any other information related to the chair, who is a manufacturer, or who is the maintenance. So those kind of information we can incorporate in those areas. Okay, and then in the right side you can see what are the dimensions we have in our BIM. Okay, first we have 3D shape, 4D scheduling, 5D estimation, sustainability, that means analysis part, and then 7D is facility management. Okay, so 3D we already know about that. The difference between 2D and 3D is as a graphical, for example, 2D means X and Y, 3D means X, Y, Z. Okay, so this is the difference between 2D and 3D. So here you can find the 3D shape, and then 4D means scheduling, that means what time, what kind of work will be completed. That one we can show by the help of our 3D model. And then 5D, the cost estimation. 6D, sustainability, analysis part. 7D, facility management. Facility management means, for example, in a mall, a shop is there. In the shop, the light, one light is not working. Okay, so each and every mall we have an individual facility management department. So we just call them and then we just inform the number of the light fixture. So each and every light fixture or each and every common light fixture, aircon, any other doorbell, everything should be have an individual code in near the light fixture or any other. We have a code there. So we just call the facility management agent and then we just inform the number to them. Then they can easily identify this light fixture or this light have the manufacturer warranty or what date it should be installed, and then warranty period expired on which date. Those kind of information we have in our model. That is we call facility management. This one we key in after our as-built model. Okay, once our as-built model finished, then we just key in this information. And then what are the leading software solution provider in this field means for 2D drawings we have AutoCAD and then Bentley. 3D model means ArchiCAD, Autodesk Revit, Tekla, Bentley, those kind of informations. 4D BIM coordination, we have Autodesk Navisworks, Tekla, BIMSight, BIM Navigator, Solibri Model Checker. 5D cost estimation, we have Costex, CostOS, Autodesk Quantity Taker. 6D UBIM FM system. 7D analysis, Autodesk GoBoard, Green Building Studio. And then leading hardware solution provider, Capricorn, Dell, HP, Lenovo. It's just information about the hardware provider. In this BIM related, this is the hardware is many main important one, because how we are use the hardware, like 16 gig of RAM or 32 gig of RAM is very useful for us to handle much heavier modeling process. Like if you are going for a Revit, if you are building more than 10 floors, then your file should be very hand. Okay, to prevent the situation, we prefer good graphics like GeForce, GTX are higher than that one, and then minimum 32 gig of RAM, 1 TB of hard disk, those kind of hardware we must. So which I explained to you through the laptop, this is called Dell. I use a Dell. So most of the, in our company, most of the laptops are Dell, and then Lenovo also we have. So this one is hardware. And then this is our BIM workflow. how the BIM working in field or working in the companies. So in a company, we have some BIM modelers for individual disciplines. Those BIM modelers are handled or controlled by BIM coordinators. Those BIM coordinators have the instruction or have guided by the BIM manager. So BIM manager can handle two or three projects, but BIM coordinator can be stable. BIM coordinator and BIM modeler can be stable in a single project only. So that is the difference between BIM manager and BIM coordinator. So the BIM manager can be or need to be handled ArchiStruxure MEP, and then all the softwares, like what are the softwares client required on this project, those all the softwares information or softwares experience those BIM manager need to be have. And then BIM coordinator need to be have an individual experience about their architecture or the own discipline, and then own discipline related softwares. So the BIM coordinator guide the BIM modelers for their projects. Are there any design related issues? They can help them to prevent and then to fulfill the client requirement. And then I plan to provide the training for Revit Architecture, Revit Structure, Revit MEP and Navisworks. Today we are going to discuss Revit MEP. So later we can discuss about architecture and structure and Navisworks. Okay, so Revit, why we are choosing Revit? Each and every company, like every modeling company or any other construction company, they are preferring Revit because Revit is a parametric software. I will explain later. AutoCAD is a non-parametric software. Revit is a parametric software. And then it's like, there's a main thing is parametric only because it's very user-friendly software to handle the model or preparing the model or preparing the 2D drawings or preparing the coordination part is very easy compared to other softwares. And then now the Revit becomes, what is it? The N number of add-in tools we have. For example, previously what I am done in the project, I'm using Dialux to calculating the lighting. Okay. So once I done the lighting calculation, I just take the extracted file from the Dialux and then I link into Revit and then I just place the light fixture manually. I just do the coordination manually. Those kind of steps I doing manually previously, like year of 2015. Now what happened? We have an add-on tool like Illumin. Illumin means it's like a individual software for specifically for lighting calculation. So in the lighting calculation, we just take the files to the Illumin tool automatically, and then we just key in the lux level, and then we just give the family of light fixtures. They can place manually as per their light fixture automatically as per their lux level, and then those family will reflect in your Revit simultaneously. We don't need too much time to spend on that. So why I am said like that means we have a n number of options they are incorporating or they are developing the Revit. So those this is the main advantage of using the Revit in the construction industry. So here I just explain Revit is a design and documentation platform that support the design, drawings and schedules required for building information modeling. Okay. So as I mentioned in the BIM, we are extracting the 3D from 2D. Here it will be happen. So we prepare the 3D model first. With the help of 3D model, we are going to extract the 2D drawings here. With the help of 3D model, we are going to prepare the 2D documentation here. And then we can do the quantity takeoff also here. And then we can do the analysis also here, like heating and cooling load analysis, structural load analysis, and then energy analysis also we can perform here in this Revit. In the 19 onwards, they are incorporating the 18 onwards, they are incorporating the energy analysis in the Revit software. Okay. So those, most of the companies have preferred the Revit regarding this reason also. One more benefit in the Revit is we have an option for work sharing process. Work sharing means we have a team working in the same file at the same time. That is very helpful for us to working by using the work sharing process. For example, I have experience in the world largest tower in Jeddah. In that project have total 214 floors. Okay. So in that project, client need only one floor. For example, client need a fourth floor, Aki structure, MNE drawing means. With the help of work sharing process, we extract the fourth floor and pass the client for checking purpose. So those kind of works is very easy in the Revit. Okay. So, and then the next step, in the Revit model, every drawing sheet, 2D and 3D view and schedule is a presentation of information from the same virtual building model. Like what they mentioned here means whatever we prepare in the 3D model is just a virtual building. So in what we done in our site, we can see directly here. So that we have virtual building here. As you work on the building model, Revit collects information about the building projects and coordinates this information across all other representation of the project. So how we are going to start the project? So how the site coordinate, first we need to set the site coordinates, how it can be looking in the site, like the same we are preparing here. So that's the one we mentioned. Revit is most useful software in the construction field. And then the Revit parametric change engine automatically coordinate changes made anywhere in model, views, drawing sheets, schedules, sections and planes. So as I mentioned earlier, it's a parametric software. If you change any one component or any one detail or anyone, for example, if you move a wall, it will be reflected in your model views, drawing sheets, schedules, section and planes. As I mentioned, if you change anything in your 3D view, it will be changed then in 2D, it will be changed in 4D like time linear. And then if you change that in 5, it will be changed in 5D, 6D and 7D also. For that BIM, we are incorporating the BIM with the help of Revit. So that one I explained there.